YouTube. I've had a breakthrough. I've had a massive freaking breakthrough. Bro, I cannot lie. The people that post on TikTok, there are some pretty corny people type shit, though. YouTube, I've had a breakthrough, okay? I found something out that I think I invented. I'm kidding. ICT invented this. I think ICT is a genius. Anyways, though, I don't know if ICT invented this, but this is called standard deviation, and it goes completely with the price's algorithmic theory. So, let's figure this out. So, let's mark out this right there. Okay. This is sexy, bro. Oh my gosh, this is super sexy. Super sexy. Okay, boys, let's lock in right now. Okay. So, whenever you are inside of a trade, all right. So, say that you entered this trade off of a fair value gap. Freaking. Oh my gosh. Okay. Downtrend. Oh, downtrend. Market structure shift fair value gap. Directly here. Market structure shift fair value gap. Okay. Now. Volume profile amounts? Nah. All right. So you entered off this fair value gap. All right. Now, let me get right down to the T here. Okay. Market structure shift fair value gap is a decent concept. So whenever you're entering the trade, you're thinking to yourself, I'm trading towards a draw on liquidity. I'm trading towards a fair value gap. I'm trading towards this fair value gap as well. You're thinking to yourself, how do I know which one to target? You know, there's also a buy side like directly here. Like, how do I know like where to have my take profit? Because what if price taps into the fair value gap and freaking dumps? What if price taps buy side liquidity and dumps, but my take profit's at the 50% mark of this fair value gap? Let me help you out, okay? So when we're trading, price will, I don't know if this is accurate. I can check if that's accurate. It's about accurate. Okay. Price will always, will almost always have a move like this before you enter. So on this trade right here, you see price made a high where you, where the swing low of is of where you entered. So say you entered right here, the swing low to the previous swing high, you mark out standard deviations. You guys want the levels right here? They're right there. Okay. Like I can hold them up for a little bit longer, but they're also right here. They're also right there. Just go back and pause the video. Okay. Now, let me make this realistic for you guys. I know you're thinking I'm moving things to make it less realistic, but I swear I'm making this more realistic because price is perfect. So I'm actually making this more realistic. Now, whenever you draw this out, you're gonna notice these levels get printed on your chart. Now, these are all possible take profit levels. So let me just go ahead and draw this out. So, every single one of these is a take profit level except for a negative one and zero. So, I might even be able to take those off my chart. I didn't really think about that. Actually, I need zero because zero is where you mark it out from. So, these are all the. I actually like negative one. I don't know why. I just like it there. So, these are all the take profit levels. Now, every single one of these. So, on the left side, you're going to have to be marking out, you know, the 5 minute fair value gaps, the PDAs, absolutely everything. You're gonna be marking out absolutely everything. If you find a thing that lines up perfectly with a fit with a standard deviation level, that's where your take profit is gonna be at. I'll show you guys a perfect example of this. Okay. So right here, price would just normally tap right into there and then algorithmically completely destroy where your stop loss would have been. Okay. So maybe in this case scenario, you wanted to target the negative 2.5 because you're thinking, oh, it's at the start of a fair value gap. Okay. There's a chance, boys. Okay, so let's hop into a real chart market example. Like price can reject off the negative two level. There's also more in more depth to this, but I'm just gonna be going over this first part, at least for now. Okay. So, as you guys can see right here, I entered the trade on the 1 minute time frame. I'll get into why I entered this trade in like another further one of my videos. But from the swing low to the swing high, previous swing high, you get these levels printed. Let's go on the 1 hour time frame and look for possible PDAs that line up with these levels. So I'm just gonna delete these and I'm gonna just mark out the levels as this. These are all the potential levels. Oopsie. Now, let's go on the 1 hour time frame and mark things out. As you can see right here, fair value gap. Doesn't line up perfectly. Right here, BPR lines up a little bit better. Right here, inverse fair value gap. Okay, so we see that they all have something like this. So that's the fact that every single one of these has a inverse fair value gap or fair value gap really isn't a big deal. Okay, because we're like, okay, it's not that crazy. So now, if we look here, we see that price has equal highs right here. But equal highs works as something called an inner level, which I can get into with you guys. But anyways, it's like a level with inside of a fair value gap. In this case, a BPR, which is even more confluence, okay? So this is what you call an inner level. It's also even called a point of control. I've heard that before. I just call it an inner level because the point of control, I think of the TPO and ATM or AMT actually, and the VPI. Like the volume profile, time price opportunity, auction market theory, okay? So I just changed it to inner level instead of point of control. But as you can see, right now we're getting these levels. We got three confluences as well as a BPR, which is the strongest confluence. Now let's hop on the 4 hour time frame and look more. Okay, this one's at a complete random point in between, the top of the fair value gap. Complete random point right there. This one, same thing. Start of the BPR though. Now the BPR is right there. All right. So that's even more confluence for price to push right into there. This can pretty much get deleted because it's like, okay, price could really push anywhere in there. This right here, still a BPR with a point of control. So still looking like a potential level. Okay, where does the BPR start? BPR starts right here, which lines up perfectly as well. So let's go back on that 3 minute time frame and analyze this. We see that a lot of confluences line up at the negative 3 and the negative 3.5. So my fault, guys. Anyways, though, the negative 3 level. So I probably just set my take profit there, okay? Because the standard deviation will tell you where to set your take profit, but you have to line it up with the draw liquidity. So you find the draw liquidity that lines up with the standard deviation, and that's almost guaranteed where price can reverse to. Now, as you can see, there's more levels lining up with the negative 3.5 as well, but the most of them are at the negative 3. So me being like conservative, I target the negative 3. But as you can see, price would have hit the negative 3.5 to the tick as well, and then algorithmically reverse from that. Okay, let's hop on to one more thing to do with standard deviations. Now, this is the same concept, but almost like inversed. All right. Say that this is what price does. And, okay, this is gonna kind of complicate some things for you guys. All right. But y'all just gotta stay locked in with me, and I'm gonna get you through this. Just trust me, trust me, trust me, trust me, trust me. No, 2.5, 2.5. Okay. So, whenever you are trying to look where to enter a trade, you will see price has a. Okay, that lines up a little bit too perfectly. That's kind of weird. I don't know if I like that. Anyways, it's fine. You'll see that price typically will give you an entry around a negative 2 to negative 2.5 level. I don't know how to put this. It's not necessarily the levels, but if there's a draw on liquidity, so say like a fair value gap right here, okay, say a fair value gap right here. What this is going to do is with the standard deviation is it's going to give you like an exact point where price will reverse off of. So for example, right here, if I was actually trying to be like realistic, like the markets, okay, price would probably have retraced into 50%. The standard deviation would probably, yeah, perfectly right there. So as you can see, we have the higher time frame PDA. Say we can, you combine this with our last video, and we see an SMT. This is literally my strategy, guys. I'm just letting you know. And we see the standard deviation lines up perfectly with the negative 2.5. That's like a guaranteed sign to enter, okay? Because you see it lines up perfectly. So just like the other one, you can enter off the negative 1.5 every single one of these levels, but you have to line it up with the proper drawn liquidity, okay? Then you just draw your standard deviations for a target. All right, you enter your trade off the first rejection candle. In this case, probably stop loss right there. Say take profit right at these highs because that lines up. And there's a really good trade that will most likely play out, okay? So, yeah, that's pretty much how you use standard deviation. So you can use it to find take profits and find out where to enter. Now, I'm letting you guys know, I'm dropping you the sauce right now, okay? This is very good things that you guys can be using in the markets, okay? I would show you guys some in-market examples, but this video is getting extremely long. It's also, like, really late, and I got tennis tomorrow morning, so I gotta go. Yeah, make sure you guys stay locked in on the markets. Don't just take my advice for everything. You know, go in the markets and back to, you know, some of these things yourself. As you can see right here, like, I can't even see if it lined up with this trade. I don't really know. I've got so many freaking lines and markets, you know, market manipulation maneuvers and all this shit, bro. Like, it's so complicated. I can see if this lines up, though. So, from here to here. I mean, yeah, it pretty much perfectly lines up with the negative 2.5 level. So, you just gotta find the drawn liquidity, which in this case was, like, an SMT. Also, this thing looks like a possible, yeah, fair value gap, 50% mark of this fair value gap. Nah, not quite 50%. Maybe, you know, 50% of this fair gap not closing below it. Anyways, though, that is pretty much the strategy. A lot to do with standard deviations, guys. So, hopefully this video helped you guys with standard deviations. I might leave a link to an ICT video on standard deviations, but I'm definitely not going to do that. So just go watch ICT's video on it. It was, like, really good. Like, dude, these things are to the tick. Like, you see a standard deviation, say, like this. So you say you're trying to enter a trade. Okay. And you see this standard deviation right here. Okay, and you line one of these levels up with the drawn liquidity, it is guaranteed that price will tap one to the tick and reverse, like, directly off of it. Assuming you have other, you know, confluences with this as well. But if you have everything lined up perfectly, this is what you will see in the markets, okay? This is telling you your exact take profit and stop loss levels in some cases. Like, in this case, potentially a stop loss level. Not really, pretty much just where to enter and take profits. Hopefully this video is helpful. This is a very informative video. I'm sorry I was talking so fast. It's super late. I'm trying to pump out some vids. Yeah. See you guys.